All right, if you want to use Google Sheets to create a task list and have it be interactive, that's what we're going to show you how to do right now. And we're just going to start out, we're going to have three columns here. One is just going to be the status. So this is where you'll come in and check things off. And then next column will have the actual task itself. So we're going to type in what you want to do. And then the third column, and this is based on some user comments on a previous video that we had on making a task list. Some people wanted a timestamp to see when it was completed. All right, so for the status, we just want a simple checkbox. So it'll be a yes or a no. So left click on insert up at the top, come down to checkbox, and you select that. What Google Sheets does is it places the little control in cell B3. And when you click on it, what it does is it's actually changing that value from false to true. So there's two possible values in B3 right now, unchecked or checked, which translates to false and true. All right, we'll leave that unchecked for now. We're just going to select a few more cells here, go back to insert and click checkbox again. And we'll say, you know, you're a simple person, right? You have four things that you really want to do, so you're focused. Let's not say simple, let's say focused. So your first task is in the morning, you want to get some fresh air. Right, the next task that you want to do is you want to eat breakfast. This has overflowed the column a little bit, so I'll come up between C and D and just double left click on the separator, and that will auto fit the column to the longest piece of content. All right, and one last thing that we should probably do is make it a little bit more obvious to the eye that these are headers and they're not part of the area that you're going to be working in. So we'll make those bold. And we will center align them, and then we'll go to the cell borders and put a bottom border on these three cells. All right, so I think that looks nice, right? We're ready to go. Now the functionality that we want to put in is once you check a task off, we want this cell to get a strike through and the background color to just kind of turn gray just to make it look like it's been done. So we would do that through conditional formatting. And when you do conditional formatting, the first step that you want to do is select the cells that you want to apply it to. You can go down a little bit further if you think this list might get longer. You can actually apply it to the entire column if you want, but we're going to keep it simple and just apply it to C3 through C6. Okay, so go to format and conditional formatting. And the apply to range is already filled out because you started with it selected. So we can skip over that. And then the rules, if you look over at the left, it's already trying to apply conditional formatting. And this is a way that you can kind of watch it as you build out the formula to see when it's working again. But what this is doing, it's pre-filled to format it if it's not empty. So all of those cells have something in them and they're getting formatted with the background fill of green. We want to change that formatting to a custom formula. Click custom formula is, and you get this empty rectangle here where it's asking for your formula. All right, we'll click in there and notice that the rectangle that surrounds it is blue right now. That means that what you have in there is not an error, but we don't have anything in there. So that's not very helpful. We'll click an equal sign and it turns red. So it's saying, I think you're typing a formula right now, but I know it's not done because it doesn't give me any result. Okay, that's expected because you're not done. We're going to type in a formula. And what we want to do, these formulas, when you have a range selected in conditional formatting, they're always written as if you're in the top left cell. So in this case, if we look at our range, that's C3. And what we want to do here is we want to see if B3 is checked. So our formula is going to say B3. And when it's checked, the value is true. You don't need quotes around this true. You would if you were looking for a certain word, but true is just a value of true or false. It's a Boolean variable, which means that it's only one of two values, and true is an actual value. It's not a string, so you don't need quotes around it. The outline of the rectangle is changed from red to blue. That's saying that this formula is working. And when you look over here, though, you don't see much going on, right? You can't tell. So let's put a check mark in one of these boxes. And that did conditionally format this cell if this box was checked. So we can tell that this rule is working, but what we want to do is we want to make it be crossed out. So we're going to add the strike through. And then let's say we want to change the fill color just to an indiscreet kind of gray. And let's even change the font while we're in here. Let's change the font to another shade of gray. All right, so that really looks like it's done, right? Now, the next thing that we want to do is based on some user feedback that I got. We had created an interactive checklist before and people were using it, but they wanted to see the time at which they completed the task. So I was able to find a kind of a useful formula for this. I'll put a link to that video in the description just to give the person credit that they came up with something where you don't need a custom script. You just do it with a couple of steps. So what I'm going to do, I already have it in this other worksheet. I'm going to grab it. And we're going to paste it in the other worksheet and we'll talk about what's happening. All right, so we'll talk about this formula, but there is one thing that you need to do first to go up to File and go to your spreadsheet settings. Click on the Calculation tab. And you need to turn Iterative Calculation to on, make sure that's on, and just change the max number of iterations to 1. All right, so save that setting. That will only apply to this particular spreadsheet. And what that's doing is this formula that's in D3 creates a loop. And you don't want Google Sheets to just do that loop infinitely. You only want it to calculate it one time. So this formula will give you an error if you don't uncheck that. So let's double click in the cell and talk about this formula. What this does is says, hey, if B3 has a check mark in it, what I want you to do, if this cell D3 isn't blank, run the now function and return that value. Otherwise, don't do anything. So I'll capitalize now just to make it look more, a little bit more formal. But the now function, we'll look at this help. It returns the current date and time as a date value, date and time. So we'll look at what that does. First, we'll copy this formula down. And it's blank now, right? But if you check one of these checkboxes, it puts the time in. If you don't want this to show the time and you only want it to show the date, you can change now to today, which is a similar function, but it's just a little, what it returns is just a little bit cleaner. And you have to uncheck this and check it again. But that's how to add a timestamp to this interactive checklist. And there is one more item. I got several comments on this other video of people asking if you can make an auto sort and move what's done to the top or the bottom. Well, there's no way to do that without writing a custom script, but what you can do if you want to do it manually is just select the table, go to data and create a filter. And then you get these controls on each of the headers where if you click on them, what you can do is sort from A to Z, and that will sort the status of these checkboxes. C to A will put them at the top. A to Z will put the completed task at the bottom. So next we're going to go a little bit deeper on how to use conditional formatting, how you can highlight an entire row based on just the value in one cell. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in that video.